springtime last year, a couple of cows or a few cows holding cleanings, and maybe the calves weren't jumping up as quick as I would like, and I thought some of the cows were even slower to calve. And after speaking to Niall there from Goulden's on a different matter, it came up in conversation, and he recommended that I maybe spread some for the second cut and we do some tests on it. And I found a great response there in the spring this year. Cows were much livelier and calves were much healthier and had very little trouble with cleanings, or nearly none at all this year, bar a few hard calvings.
So from talking to Seamus last spring and realising how many cows had held their cleanings and probably the response of the calves to the grass, we went ahead and we done a herbage analysis on his grass, and we went ahead and done a bulk mill screening. Both results showing that he was deficient in selenium. And then that's backed up by Chagas trials showing that cows only receive 30% of their daily requirement from grass. Well, usually selenium has got into the cow through either a concentrate source or a mineral. Goulden's have a selenium fertility program in place. It's probably the most convenient and simple way for a farmer to get selenium into the grass. So it's by simply spreading selenium in the fertilizer, cow can utilize the selenium in the grass, and they'll get a consistent source of selenium throughout the grazing year and in their grass silage.
I'm going to spread it for first and second cut silage. There are probably 4 bags to the acre for the first cut, and I got such a good response from it. I'm also going to spread some on the cow paddocks, maybe some sweet grass there with selenium in it as well.
Goulden's, in conjunction with Glanbia, for a good few years now have been doing an awful lot of work on selenium in fertiliser. Right from the top of the Glanbia catchment area to the bottom, we've seen consistent low levels of selenium across the board in herbage analysis with them. Glanbia do an awful lot of grass and soil samples every year, all showing low, anything from 0.01 to 0.067. Chagas recommend that your result should be around 0.3 milligrams per kilo. So our aim is, after a 4 bag program on grazing and per silage cut, that you'll reach 0.3 milligrams per kilo, and we've consistently proven that, as we've done here with Seamus after we've done the program. It's a 4 bag program. You can mix and match them 4 bags. We have selenium in a few standard products, so urea, Selene Start, we have it in Stray Nitrogen, Selene Grass, and a grazing compound, Selene Graze, which is 24.5, 2.5, 5. And we also have a silage product, Selene Cut, which is 20, 2, 12. So a combined effort of those products on the grazing ground at 4 bags, as I said, will ensure enough adequate selenium level on the grazing platform. And 4 bags per acre per silage cut, again, will bring it up. We can basically put selenium in any fertiliser. 18-6-12 in the last couple of years becoming a huge product with selenium, just for the added need, obviously, of P&K on farm nowadays.
So the 3 benefits of using selenium in your fertiliser are: fertility is improved, there's a 41% improvement in first service conception, immunity is improved, and held cleanings, there's an 88% reduction in held cleanings by using selenium.